Vistalant saw its first half bottom line grow 83%. Chairman Manny Villar attributes this to the launch of 24 billion pesos worth of projects nationwide. He also says the company's reservation sales performance in the first semester rose 12%. Vistalant shares rose 0.6%. San Miguel Corporation posts an 18% growth in its first half bottom line. The company points to sustained improvements in its infrastructure, beer, and packaging units. It also cites the acquisition of Eagle Cement. SMC shares rose 0.8%. As for Frutas Holdings, it saw a 48% increase in its first half net income to 43.5 million pesos. Total net revenues during this period reached 1 billion pesos due to same-store sales growth, business expansion, and the addition of Lingnam store operations. The company shares fell 3.6%. And finally, Double Dragon's consolidated net income in the first half grows to 1.6 billion pesos as its revenues jump 16%. Its rental income also rose 20% to nearly 2 billion pesos. The company reports its debt to equity ratio stays at a healthy 0.68. Double Dragon shares climb 0.7%.
Asian markets ended Tuesday trade on a mixed note following a big data miss by China and better-than-expected GDP numbers from Japan. The Nikkei 225 climbed more than 0.5% after Japan's second quarter GDP report showed the economy posted its third straight quarterly expansion at 6.2%. Chinese shares, meanwhile, booked losses after retail sales and industrial output grew less than expected in July. Not even the People's Bank of China's move to cut key policy rates for a second time in 3 months provided a lift to investors' sentiment. Some notable stock movements in the region. Shares of Country Garden rebounded after plunging to a record low of more than 18% the previous day as a property giant sought to delay payment on a private onshore bond for the first time. Also bucking the regional downswing, the electric vehicle unit of cash-strapped China Evergrande Group, which announced a $3.2 billion plan to reduce debt and stay afloat. Here at home, Philippine shares saw modest gains, with the main index picking up 0.1%.
I wish I could be the bringer of good news, no? But given the slower GDP that we have, given the higher energy prices that we have, the weakening peso, so much concerns, no?
Right.
And it's the ghost month. We're in the third quarter, which is a seasonally weak part of the year.
Okay.
So I wouldn't be surprised if we still continue to go lower from here.
Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of four U.S. banking giants after Fitch warned it may have to downgrade the Bank of America, Bank of New York Mellon, J.P. Morgan Chase, and State Street to A+. These four currently possess the A- rating. Bank of New York Mellon and State Street were also recently downgraded by Moody's. Also in focus, shares of Home Depot after it reported earnings per share and revenue that beat expectations. Home Depot shares, though, are down in pre-market trading. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of Marks & Spencer, which raised its profit outlook on strong sales in its stores. Shares of the British retailer are trading nearly 7% higher at 219 pennies sterling apiece. We're also keeping an eye on shares of Vietnamese EV maker VinFast, which is set to debut on the Nasdaq Tuesday. So far, shares are rising in pre-market trade.
Let's check on European markets first. They're down in midday trade with China's growth worries continuing to dampen sentiment. London's FTSE 100 leading losses after the unemployment rate in the UK unexpectedly rose to 4.2% in June, higher than May's 4% figure. As for Wall Street, futures are also pointing to a lower open ahead of the US July retail sales data.